Hachette Audio presents Becoming a Dangerous Woman, Embracing Risk to Change the World. Written and read by Pat Mitchell. To all the dangerous women and the men who stand with us, who have inspired me to share my stories, and whose work compels me to embrace the risk necessary to make the world a safer, more equitable place for all women and girls. To our children and grandchildren, for whose futures I have become a dangerous woman. Preface: The Most Dangerous Woman in the Room. Instructions for living a life. Pay attention. Be astonished. Tell about it. Mary Oliver, from a stitched note called Sometimes. Yes, I'll be there. Eve Ensler was calling with an invitation to what she described as the meeting of movements planned for the first week of January 2017. In the wake of a polarizing presidential election in the United States, Eve had decided it was time for activists to come together to shape the strategies that could unify and leverage the collective power of a wide range of social justice organizations. Who else is coming? I asked. I'm not releasing the invitation list, Eve replied. But you'll want to be in the room. Indeed, I did want to be in that room, knowing from past experiences that any meeting or event that Eve Ensler organized would be meaningful. So I showed up, as the invitation indicated, at a nondescript building in Stone Ridge, New York, and surrendered my cell phone to the smiling young volunteer at the front door. Best to have all communication devices outside the room, was the explanation, which of course heightened my anticipation about what would transpire within this room. I entered a large room and saw Eve standing at the front with folding chairs in a circle. Mingling about the room were some familiar faces, the meeting's other conveners, Kimberly Crenshaw of the African American Policy Forum, Naomi Klein, award-winning author and activist, independent media entrepreneur and journalist Laura Flanders, and Jane Fonda, actor and activist. We were asked to find our seats, and Eve began. "We are living in dangerous times," was her opening line. "And such times call for new levels of activism from all the communities represented in this circle. Let's begin by identifying who's in the room." One by one, the introductions began. "I'm one of the founders of the Women's March." "I'm the executive director of 350.org. "I run Project South." With each introduction, the level of leadership and activist credentials became more impressive, and for me, more intimidating. I could feel my anxiety building. How was I going to identify myself? I had no title and was no longer running an organization. Having left my last CEO position at the Paley Center for Media the previous spring, I could say I was the CEO of Pat Mitchell Media, with its grand total of 2 employees, including myself, but that felt wholly inadequate to explain why I belonged in that room. I mentally rehearsed some other options. I could say I was a lifetime advocate for women. True enough, if a little vague. I could list my previous titles. But why make a point of being the former anything? I was struggling to come up with how to identify myself in the present, an identity that would hopefully give some indication of why Eve had included me in this circle of activists and leaders. Finally, it was my turn. Before I knew it, I heard myself saying, "I'm Pat Mitchell, and I'm a dangerous woman." I'm not sure exactly what prompted this personal declaration of dangerousness, but I could tell from the looks of surprise that I needed to add a bit more context. At this time in my life, about to turn 75, I continued, I have nothing left to prove, less to lose, and I'm ready to take more risk and to be less politic and polite. As Eve said, these are dangerous times, and dangerous times call for dangerous women. That got a big sisterly yes from Eve and others in the circle, including Jane Fonda, who was sitting across from me and stood up declaring, "Well, I'm older than my friend Pat, so that makes me even more dangerous." Laughter erupted, of course, and I could sense that others were contemplating exactly what becoming more dangerous to meet the challenges of dangerous times would mean for each of us and for the work we had convened to consider. Certainly, Jane Fonda's life of activism is a textbook case for being bold and brave. During our many years of friendship, I've witnessed her willingness to take risk for a good cause, to speak out and show up, even when it meant personal peril or sacrifice. At 81, she is still on the front lines, campaigning for domestic and restaurant workers' rights, standing with the American Indian communities, protesting natural resource exploitation at Standing Rock, and busier as an actor than ever. In her book, Prime Time, Jane advanced the idea that older women have the potential to become the most powerful population on the planet. She's a great example of how we embrace that potential at every age. My personal potential for becoming more dangerous is perhaps more directly linked to my friendship with Eve Ensler. From our first conversation in war-torn Sarajevo in 1998, I have been deeply inspired by her courage and her commitment to doing whatever is necessary to end violence against women everywhere. Taking risk comes easier to Eve than to many. Writing and performing the vagina monologues, making it the centerpiece of a global movement, V-Day, to end gender-based violence, is a transformative approach to activism that I feel privileged to have experienced. Yes, I was an activist and woman's advocate before I met Eve Ensler, but through my relationship with her, and as a board member of the V-Day movement, I've met activists facing dangers every day to create change in some of the most difficult places on earth to be a woman. But until that day, I had not felt dangerous myself. Declaring myself a dangerous woman still feels a bit, well, dangerous, and I readily admit to some second thoughts about declaring it even more widely and boldly as the title of this book. But every day since that convening, I'm discovering more about what being dangerous means in my life and why I believe that it's time for us, women and the men who stand with us, at whatever age or place in life's journey, to embrace risk and engage with renewed passion and collective purpose in the truly dangerous work of making the world a safer place for women and girls. I have had to face my own questions and those of others, about the definition of dangerous in this work. For me, it doesn't mean being feared, but being more fearless. It does mean speaking the truth when silence is safer, showing up for one another, even within the patriarchal construct that encourages us to compete and compare. And it does mean speaking out about the politics and policies that divide us and diminish our individual and collective power. It also means optimizing that power to be effective in allying with those who don't have access to opportunity, influence, or privilege. It also means, for me, sharing our stories, as women have done for generations, to survive, thrive, and move forward. That's why I'm sharing my journey from small-town South Georgia girl with big dreams, but little means to realize them. No money, no connections, no power or sphere of influence. To media executive with influence. To where I am today, more prepared to leverage my privilege, platforms, and connections to optimize every opportunity to elevate other women and their stories, and to support their struggles and celebrate their accomplishments. My story began in an unlikely place, on my grandparents' small cotton farm with no electricity or indoor toilets. But what I had in those early years was a grandmother who could wring a chicken's neck with one arm and churn butter or pump water with the other while telling me fanciful stories of places she had never seen. Stories that ignited an intense curiosity that is at the heart of everything I have done in my life and work. By taking some early risk and leaps of faith in myself, I escaped the limitations of resources and pushed past barriers, sometimes helping to dismantle them, while often coping with the challenges of being the first or only woman. Very early on, I learned the value of nurturing connections, of building and sustaining.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.